Moses says to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, ever since God created people upon the earth, ask from one end of the sky to the other, did anything so great ever happen before? Do people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and live? Or did any God venture to take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation, by testings, by signs and wonders, by war with a strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on the earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep God's commandments, so that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have long life in this land, which your God is giving you forever." When we fail to come to the defense of the time since they lit up the Father's garden, Joan's voices were silent.
Where are my voices? Why have you abandoned me?
Joan had languished in prison for a year and a half and endured many harrowing examinations. She was threatened with torture. Her king and her church, the two things she had served and loved above all else, abandoned her. The church fathers refused her Eucharist, but for Joan was starvation more acute than being denied food. She was excommunicated, convicted of heresy and witchcraft, and sentenced to be burned at the stake. She was 19. Spoke truth to bishops and kings. She was a